Hey guys, one quick little thing before we get the video started is that for those sensitive viewers, you may or may not want to watch this video because my hat here has a special little thing about it, and that special little thing is flashing little Christmas lights. So if you are in any way photosensitive or epileptic, please don't watch this video, okay? Alright. Just wanted to get that out there. Sorry, but I just want to be as festive as possible, and this is the most festive thing I have right now. So, yeah, I don't have my SpongeBob Christmas hat that I usually do, and I don't have any other Christmas hats right now. So, I hope you guys can understand, and I know this may disappoint a few of you, but I'm doing this because I want to be festive, and I am more than fully well aware of epilepsy and the dangers it can cause, so... if you are in any way epileptic, please don't watch this video. And for the rest of you, enjoy. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Yes, it's Christmas time. And as you can see, I'm all decked out. What's up? What's happening? What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Anime Station, the most specific for anything and everything animation. Now we are finally doing something animated after a whole month of doing something non-animated, pretty much. And it's something else I've wanted to do for a while. It's another serial review. And it's fitting I wear this hat because I actually have a Christmas-themed serial for you guys today. And I believe there's two of them. And I have one of them here, and then... I think the other one, what's the other one? Is it Frosty? One of the other classic Christmas specials has its own cereal. I can't remember which one it is right now. But the one we're going to be looking at today, and for today's review, is this one right here. For any of you that saw one of my other videos from the end of Legends of Literature, you would have already seen this. But for the rest of you that don't, this is the General Mills Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer cereal. It's supposed to taste like hot cocoa. I don't know how, but we're going to try it. So let's go over the box real quickly. I'm going to go to this side. We have the Rudolph logo right there. Family size right there. General Mills. Nice big picture of Rudolph himself in all his stop motion glory right there. Have a little ornament telling you what flavor it's supposed to be. Hot cocoa. And then a little bit of a look at it there. And then moving to the side, it tells us everything that's included in here. You have the flying reindeer as your... you know, your base, and then you have Rudolph's red nose, the Christmas tree, and Hermes hat for your marshmallows. And then we have a cute little illustration here of Clarice and Rudolph, which is cute. And then this side has all your facts, so parents, you can go ahead and pause this right now if you need to know what the sugars are. I'll give you about 10 seconds. Okay. And then here's the rest of it there. And then on the back, for the kids, there's some neat little activities here. They talk about some reindeer games you can play. And on the bottom, when you finish your cereal, you can actually cut out this little two-sided cardboard ornament of Rudolph and put it on your tree. So it's pretty cool. This thing has about, let me see. How much sugar is in this thing? If I can maybe find it on... here it is. 12 grams. Yeah, it has a decent bit of sugar in it, but it's not, like, super sugary. Like, it's not, like, 15, 20 grams, so... it's on the lighter side, but it is still pretty sugary. I'd say it's probably, I think, about on the same sugar length as the Sonic the Hedgehog cereal that we looked at way, way back. So, yeah. I have not opened this yet, because I had to finish another cereal first, but... now that it is the Christmas season and that box of cereal is gone, we can review and taste test this one right here. So, without any further ado, let's dive in. Alright, I opened this off camera just now because it usually takes me a while to open these things, you know, having one hand and everything. So, but this one's actually one of the easier ones, so, I don't know, maybe I was just being stupid, so... before we even taste the cereal, let's get a good whiff. Let's sniff it. Ooh, yeah, that is a strong cocoa scent. So let's take out one piece of each. take a look at it in depth. Here's your hot cocoa flavored flying reindeer. I know my camera's not going to focus, but that's the basic idea. And then we have 3 marshmallows in here. We have something I just dropped on the floor. Give me a second. It's fine. It didn't hit that. The floor is not that dirty. I literally just cleaned it 2 days ago. We have Rudolph's nose, which is supposed to be red, but it came out more of a pink color, which is a bit strange. Maybe it's supposed to be his nose lighting up. That would make sense. So yeah, we have Rudolph's nose. Then there's... where is it? Yes. We have a little Christmas tree right there. It's not super special, but it's there. It's a Christmas tree. And then there's one more. There's supposed to be blue ones in here of Hermes' hat. Is it this one? Nope, that's another tree. Might have to shake the bag up a little. No, I see one. No, not that one. Sorry, it's taking a sec, guys. Nope, that's another tree. There are a lot of trees in here. Try and grab a handful. There's one. Alright. It took me a minute because it's like really buried in there, but here's Hermes' hat. Or what's supposed to look like Hermes' hat. Or like this. It's supposed to be like his blue elf hat, which is actually kind of neat. So, yep, we got that. I also have a solo cup here. So we can just dump it in whenever we're ready and get a handful. But first, let's taste each one individually. Let's start with the biggest difference with this one. Obviously, the hot cocoa-flavored flying reindeer. I'm not usually into chocolate cereal, but I'm willing to give this one a try. So let's try it out together. 3, 2, 1. It is very chocolatey, but reminds me a lot of like the, I've tasted this chocolate before, I'm trying to remember. Oh, it tastes like the Reese's chocolate. In the Reese's Puff cereal, when you have the little chocolate ones, and then you have the peanut butter ones, this tastes like a chocolate one. Pretty good. I'm not gonna lie, it tastes pretty good. Alright, let's try the marshmallows. They should all taste the same, but just in case. We'll go with the nose first. Yep, that tastes exactly like I thought it would. The hat. Yep. These all just taste like normal marshmallows. It's really more just for aesthetic. Okay. Alright, now for this other test, I'm going to bring in the solo cup. And I'm going to pour some this into that cup. If I end up liking this enough, this might end up becoming my holiday snack. Since obviously candy canes will have to be for the tree. There we go. Just seal it back up. Seal it like you do with all other cereal boxes. Just put this tab under this tab. Should be pretty good. Though that, sometimes that thing is inconsistent. Like the one on the Ninja Turtles Mutant Mayhem cereal we also reviewed a while back. It has a tendency of popping out. Then again, that was also a smaller box too. Whereas this is a lot more like the Miraculous cereal that we tried as well. It's even family size to kind of match with that one. So, all right, let's stop messing around here. I got a solo cup full of cereal. Let's just grab a handful and see how it all tastes together. If I can try to get at least one of each piece in one handful. Give me a second. This might take a minute. And then one of these. And a tree. There we go. Alright, we got one handful. I can maybe not shake the table because my camera's sitting on it. Yeah, sorry, I have a really small hand. Alright, let's see how this all tastes together. And, like I said before, I'm a dry cereal eater. I don't eat cereal with milk because then it gets soggy and it turns all, like, nasty. If you know what I mean? So, if I can really pick this up. There we go. Alright, you guys ready? One, two, three. That's really good. Like, it's very much like hot cocoa. You know, like, you know how sometimes they say it's supposed to taste like something, but ends up tasting nothing like that at all? This tastes like hot cocoa. Like, or at least the reindeer parts do. I can't really taste the marshmallows in that pile. So, yeah. That's pretty good cereal, man. I'm not gonna lie to you. Dry, anyway. I'm not, like I said, if you want to know how this tastes with milk, go watch someone else's review. I'm here for the dry cereal people. The weird people. One more handful. This is really good. Oh, yeah. That's really good. Like, yes, just Lucky Charm marshmallows with little cornflakes that taste like the Reese's chocolate and the peanut butter and the Reese's Puffs cereal, but it's a really good combination. Like, I'm impressed. It's actually pretty good. Like, I kind of bought this more as a joke for a Christmas review, but I ended up really liking this. Yeah. I actually really like this. I dig it. So, let's get to the final verdict of the cereal overall. It's delicious. It's great. It's perfect for the holiday season. If you love Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer and you want to get your kids some festive flavored cereal, well, this one's right here for you. It's limited edition. It should be available through all of December, and maybe into early January if you're lucky, but this is a pretty good cereal. I actually really like it. Is it better than the Miraculous cereal? No. Is it better than the Sonic cereal? No. But I really like it. I dig this. So let me think. I gave the Sonic one a 10. I think I gave the Miraculous one a 9. So by default, this will probably be about on the same length as the Mutant Mayhem cereal. If I remember the score I gave for that one. It's been so long since I've done one of these reviews. So, yeah. I'd say final verdict for the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer Hot Cocoa Cereal is a strong 8 out of 10. If you have not tried this yet, give it a try. It's perfect for the holiday season. Kids will like it. Just maybe don't buy more than one box, though, because 12 grams is a lot of sugar. So, yeah. It's a little bit sugary, but it's delicious. It's great. It tastes like hot cocoa. I think you're really going to like it. Well, that's it for this special bonus review. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. So take care, enjoy your cereal, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.